What would happen if a brown dwarf entered the solar system? Each planet in the solar system has a unique orbit. No planet shares its orbit with another, and thanks to this, they never collide. But what would happen if, one day, some unexpected event or an object from interstellar space entered our solar system and caused one of the planets to fall out of orbit? What would happen if the planets fell out of their orbit due to the influence of a brown dwarf? Keep watching to find out. The first thing you should know is that the planets cannot get out of their orbits by themselves, just like that. This is because all the planets, including the Earth, obtain their orbits around the Sun during their formation processes. The planets form from a disk of gas and dust called a protoplanetary disk that orbited the Sun more than 5 billion years ago. What is a protoplanetary disk? The protoplanetary disk is a gas disk of various chemical elements that form around a young star. It originates from a cloud of gas and dust that gravitationally collapses due to gravity. As the cloud contracts, it begins to spin faster due to the conservation of angular momentum. This leads to the formation of a flattened disk around the star at its center. The protoplanetary disk is a very active place where dust and small objects come together to form larger bodies. These bodies, known as planetesimals, can join together to form planets. Planetesimals gravitationally attract each other, leading them to collide and merge. As planetesimals merge, larger bodies known as protoplanets and later planets such as Earth are formed. During the entire process, the planets also acquire their orbits through a process known as accretion. As planetesimals merge to form protoplanets, these bodies draw in more gas and dust from the protoplanetary disk. This increases their mass and gravitational pull, which pulls more material towards them. As the protoplanet becomes more massive, its gravity influences nearby planetesimals' motion and the protoplanetary disk's gas. These objects begin to orbit the protoplanet, and as they accumulate, rings of material are formed in orbit around the protoplanet. These rings can merge to form moons or even be absorbed by the protoplanet to increase its mass. As the protoplanet grows and attracts more material, its gravity becomes more massive and its orbit stabilizes. Eventually, the protoplanet becomes a complete planet with a defined orbit around the Sun. That is why each planet has its orbit around the Sun, because initially, when they formed, they absorbed all the matter in that area, so there cannot be two planets sharing the same orbit. When a planet fails to absorb all the matter from the protoplanetary disk, small moons form around it. Even though planets can't share their orbits, why don't they fall out of their orbits once they're formed? Isn't the Sun supposed to attract all the planets with its gravitational pull? Why don't planets fall towards the Sun? The Sun pulls the planets with gravity, but they do not fall towards the Sun due to their orbital motion. A moving object has an amount of kinetic energy associated with its speed and its mass. If no forces act on the object, it will move in a straight line at a constant speed. However, in a system like the solar system, a gravitational force is acting on the planets exerted by the Sun. This force bends the motion of the planets, causing them to move in elliptical orbits around the Sun. The speed at which the planets move in their orbits is sufficient to counteract the gravitational force of the Sun. This speed is known as the orbital speed and is determined by the planet's distance from the Sun and by the mass of the Sun. As the planet moves in its orbit, the gravitational force of the Sun changes its direction, but not its magnitude, and the planet continues to move in its elliptical orbit. It's important to note that the planets are in dynamic equilibrium with the gravitational force of the Sun and their inertia. Dynamic equilibrium refers to the balance between the gravitational force of the Sun and the centrifugal force generated by the orbital motion of the planets. If a planet's orbital speed were too low, the Sun's gravitational force would pull it towards the center. And if it were too high, the planet would move away from the Sun and leave the solar system. Therefore, the planets are in a dynamic equilibrium in which the centrifugal force pulling them away from the Sun is balanced by the gravitational force pulling them towards it. This means that the only way to get the planets out of their orbits is to break that balance with an object outside the solar system, such as a star, a planet, or a brown dwarf. an unwanted visitor. If an object from the interstellar medium, such as a star or a brown dwarf, were to get a little closer to our solar system or even manage to enter the domain of the Sun entirely, it could disturb the orbits of the planets. In a previous video, we talked about what would happen if a star entered the solar system and took the Earth out of its orbit. If you haven't seen it, we'll leave it in the description of this video so you can see it. In that video, we explained that a star could push Earth out of the solar system. But if instead of a star it was a smaller object like a brown dwarf or gas giant planet like Jupiter, then instead of pulling the planets out of the solar system, it would only move their orbits. Suppose it's the case of a brown dwarf. A brown dwarf is a celestial object between a star and a planet in size and mass. It has a mass less than a star, but more significant than a planet. Unlike stars that get their energy from hydrogen fusion, brown dwarfs get their energy from deuterium fusion, and therefore they do not shine. They just emit a lot of radiation in the form of heat and infrared waves. If a brown dwarf were to enter the solar system, the first to feel its effects would be the outermost planets and finally the rocky planets. In the case of Neptune and Uranus, these planets orbit the Sun for 165 and 84 years respectively, meaning that if the brown dwarf moved very fast on its way to the Sun, it might not even run into the path of any of these two planets. Because the orbits of Uranus and Neptune are so long and they move very slowly, if the brown dwarf enters the solar system just as these two planets are on the opposite side of the Sun, it could cross their orbits in a short time until it reaches Saturn without interfering in any way with Uranus and Neptune. But on the other hand, if the brown dwarf is moving very slowly, it could affect the orbits of these two planets, in the worst case, causing them to move away from the Sun a little but not remove them altogether. Then we have Saturn. This planet has an orbit of 29.5 years, that is, it moves much faster than Uranus and Neptune, and therefore the influence of a massive object such as a brown dwarf could quickly push it as far into the solar system as outward. If Saturn moves away from the Sun like Uranus and Neptune, it will have longer years, but nothing else will happen. On the other hand, if it gets a little closer to the Sun, the consequences would be catastrophic. Saturn's rings are made mainly of rocks and ice. Likewise, its moons are made chiefly of frozen volatile elements such as water, methane, or hydrogen. All of these objects that orbit around Saturn are kept frozen because they are far enough from the Sun. But if they got closer to the interior of the solar system, they would receive more light, that is, more heat from the Sun. Due to this, they would begin to melt or sublime, since they would not go from the solid state to the liquid, but would go from the solid state directly to the gaseous state, becoming vapor. If Saturn were to get close to the Sun, it would lose its asteroid ring and almost all of its moons quickly, which would be the worst thing to happen. The planet that fares better is probably Jupiter because it has a lot of mass. Even a brown dwarf would have trouble moving a planet as gigantic as Jupiter. Thanks to this, not even the influence of a brown dwarf would take this massive planet out of its orbit. At most, the gravitational influence of a brown dwarf would disturb the orbits of some of its moons, but they would not escape Jupiter's gravity. Once we get closer to the Sun, things become more violent. When the brown dwarf approaches the asteroid belt, it will disturb the area, causing several of them to move toward the Sun or shoot out of the solar system. This would not be very pleasant for Earth, as we would be showered with asteroids. On the other hand, rocky planets are much lighter and smaller than gigantic brown dwarfs, so their force of gravity would be more than enough to move them from their orbits quickly. In the case of Mars and Earth, they will probably be pushed out of their orbits, away from the Sun. If the Earth does not move too far, it could still be within the habitable zone. In this case, things wouldn't change much. We'd just have longer years, and the seasons would last longer, but life could go on. On the other hand, if the Earth moves too far away, the temperatures could be too low, turning the planet into a snowball. The oceans would freeze, the forests and deserts would be covered in snow, and all living things would die of cold. The only survivors would be those animals that managed to adapt to living underground. Humans could also adapt different survival systems to survive in underground cities and obtain energy through different methods, such as burning fuels or geothermal energy from inside the Earth. Mars would not undergo any changes. However, if this planet moves too far from the Sun, it could end up being trapped by Jupiter's gravity. If this happens, Mars would become a moon of Jupiter and would become the largest moon of the gas giant, dethroning Ganymede, the current largest satellite of Jupiter and the largest in the entire solar system. On the other hand, if the brown dwarf gets too close to the Sun, Mercury and Venus will likely be absorbed by the Sun or the brown dwarf. In either case, it would be the end for both planets. Eventually, the brown dwarf would continue on its way until it left the solar system, leaving behind a trail of destruction that would completely change the appearance of the solar system to how it was before an unwanted visitor upset the perfect balance in which everything was found. As we see, moving the planets out of their orbits is not a great idea. Everything is perfectly balanced, and each planet is where it belongs. Let's hope that no strange object from outer space will shortly break this excellent balance that allows life to exist on our planet.